Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, everyone. My name is Nur Zafira Imam binti Muhammad Nasri. I am going to give a speech for subject BEF 4122 English for Proficiency Public Speaking. In this speech, I will tell you about my own experience during the MCO due to the pandemic COVID-19. Movement Control Order or MCO started when the number of individuals infected with COVID-19 in Malaysia rose sharply. At that time, people paid less attention and took precautions at the beginning of the existence of this virus because they thought that the virus would disappear quickly and harmless. Therefore, due to the increase in the number of patients and new clusters, the government has decided to implement MCO as a measure to reduce the risk of COVID-19 spread. Therefore, the public is not allowed to leave the house during the MCO period unless the head of the household and all work must be carried out from home. Now, let's jump into my experience. The first one is, have a lot of assignment to do and online classes. I think not only me feel the burden of having so many tasks, all my friends also feel the same. While the frontliner were working hard to treat COVID-19 patients, I was at war with preparing too many assignments from lecturers, and that made me stressed to work on them. Initially, lecturers started giving assignments, quizzes and tutorials through Google Classroom platform, WhatsApp, Telegram, and also had to be answered online as well. It was so stressful, plus I have to attend online classes every day. Although it is not physically tired, but believe me, my mental are very tired when it is difficult to understand when the lecturer teach in the online classes. I have to work hard to complete the assignment given before the deadline and have to find additional notes to understand each of the things taught. Since the online classes were held during MCO, I was just busy attending online classes that start at 8:30 a.m. and ended at 5:30 p.m. Sometimes, I had to do the task given until late at night and didn't have enough sleep. As a result, sometimes I fall asleep during online classes because I can't stand the drowsiness. As a result, I lack understanding of everything the lecturers were teaching at the time. It is difficult for me to fully understand what the lecturer is teaching, and it is difficult for me to ask questions if I do not understand. Apart from that, due to the long MCO period, students are still not allowed to return to campus and have to answer the final exam online. Although it is fine because it is considered as an open book test, but the questions given are quite difficult and there are no answers on the internet or notes. I had to think deeper to type the correct answer. Secondly, I experienced to do a part-time job to help family. Due to the increase of COVID-19 cases, I took this initiative to work and raise extra money to help my family. Since the existence of this MCO, it has restricted the movement of my family members to go to work. Because all our family members are at home, household expenses also increase and it is not possible for only one person to go to work. I also have the opportunity to experience in the fields of employment even though the salary is not as high but able to help the family to some extent. I have to divide my time between attending online classes and also working time. Thankfully, I got a kind heart boss and understood the problem and constraint I face. In a week, I only work for 2 days, which is on Saturday and Sundays only. Through my salary, I can buy kitchen necessities. I also have my own spending money without having to ask for money from my parents. I felt quite proud to be able to give money to them even though it wasn't much, but that was the result of my own hard work. Besides doing part-time work, I also find other side income like being a dropship. Although the income is not much, but it gave me a lot of motivation to continue doing business without giving up. Lastly, I experienced to moving out to a new house during the MCO period. Since the government run the MCO, many people who have been affected both economically and socially are no exception to my family. Due to the long and extended duration of the MCO, many employees are given long leave and laid off because the employer is no longer able to pay the employee salaries. My family income is not enough to cover daily expenses. My family and I decided to move to a cheaper house because the current rent is too high. After 2 weeks of looking for a cheap rental house, my family and I finally found a house that was cheaper and not too burdensome. The new house happens to be very close to my place of work and that makes me easier to go to work. Last but not least, MCO gave a lot of tension to many people and had given a lot of negative impacts, especially to low-income family. But we all know that what government do is to prevent this COVID-19. This is not the responsibility of the government alone, but we also play an important role to curbing this COVID-19 epidemic. Also, to seek knowledge and succeed for the sake of a bright future is not easy. Many assignments as well as tutorials by lecturers are common things for students. Just consider it as a challenge in achieving success because this may not be felt when we are in environment of work later. That's all from me. Thank you for lending me your ears. All the mistakes come from myself. I also want to thank my lecturer for guiding me to make this video. Thank you until we meet again. Bye!